Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to be talking about Index Lifecycle Management, or ILM, with Logstash. Index Lifecycle Management is the mechanism that rolls over the indexes at a specific age or size or a document count, for example. And you set a policy and you tell it how long or how big the index gets before it rolls over to a new index, and those indexes travel through the data tiers, hot to warm to cold to deletion. If you use Beats, the index lifecycle management is set up by default and you can edit that. But if you're using Logstash, if you're ingesting data from any source through Logstash, you're doing some filtering and parsing and then sending that to Elasticsearch, you'll need to have to set up ILM manually so that the indexes can travel through the data tiers and get deleted so they don't stay forever. I will show you here my setup. This is what I have. So I have a firewall sending syslogs to an ingestion server. I am running FileBeat and ingesting that to the Elasticsearch cluster, and I'm also running Logstash so that I can show you for this tutorial how to set up ILM. And I'm going to be working here on the Elasticsearch cluster and on the ingestion VM running Logstash on this one. So I'm going to show you the indexes that are created by Logstash. Here I'm going to index management and I called mine firewall. Okay, I am creating an index every day just using the output, the Elasticsearch output plugin in Logstash, and I will show you here my configuration file. Let me see. This output section here in Elasticsearch, I'm sending to my nodes, and I'm calling the index firewall dash, and this variable which captures the date, and it is right here, firewall the date. So every day it creates a new index and the data is being sent to Elasticsearch under that new index name. And these are the ILM settings. I have them commented out right now. And if you go under the Logstash documentation Elasticsearch output plugin, you can find those settings here, ILM, under index lifecycle management. So you'll add those under the Elasticsearch output plugin in your configuration file, just like right here. But you have to do a few steps first. So the first thing we have to do is under index lifecycle policies, you'll have to create a policy and give it a name. For example, firewall index policy. And the hot phase here, for example, you want to enable rollover, and I don't want to use the recommended defaults. I'm going to be using, for example, maximum documents, maximum age of 1 day, or maybe I'll just say five minutes, just to show you that it did the rollover. So I'm going to be indexing whatever data I'm indexing. It's gonna hit this policy. It's gonna roll over every 5 minutes. This is just for testing, so you'll do what is suitable for your environment. And I'm not going to set up warm phase or cold phase. Just gonna delete after whatever 5 days. This is just for testing. So I created the policy first, and then I'm going to create an index template second. Okay, so create template. The name is, I'll just say firewall index template. The index pattern, so index pattern to apply to the template. So I'm gonna say firewall dash star, so anything that matches firewall dash star. I'm gonna say next. Component templates, these are optional. I'm not gonna use any of those templates. I'm gonna say next. Index settings, this is where you set up, for example, they gave you here an example number of replicas for each shard. Shards make up an index. And other things, I have the settings here, and I'm gonna add those. I'm gonna add those here. So the settings that I'm going to be specifying are the lifecycle name, which is the policy name that I just created, so it has to match the in the template, it has to match the policy that I created, and the rollover alias. And I'll go next. And mappings are optional, but for example, if you have, I'll show you here, whatever data you have, you'll have to look at the fields that you have and see what you want to convert them to. So for example, I have a field called destination IP. I'm gonna make it an IP type. I'm gonna add another one for source IP. And mapping is a different topic, so it'll be its own thing. You can look at your data here that you're ingesting. I'm just gonna show you real quick. So under this index, this is my logstash ingested index. I have all these fields and they're all in text format. If I search destination IP, I see it here in text format, or in it's a text field. So I'm just gonna map it to an IP field, to be an IP field. I'm gonna say next, aliases. I'm not gonna set up any aliases. You shouldn't set the alias here in the template. Do not let the template set the alias. You will do that explicitly when you create the first index. Okay, I'm gonna say next. And before you create the template, you can go to request here, and you see this request, this API request. You can copy this whole thing and go to the DevTools, to the console here, and paste it. And if you wanna, and you, if you wanna do more, if you wanna customize it more, you can do that. Or if you wanna keep it here, and for whatever index you're working with, you just create a new policy, change the policy here, and just click play here, or click create to create the new template that you want. But before I do that, I'm just gonna get everything ready. So we created the policy first, then we create the template. The next thing is I'm going to do is I'm just gonna get this ready. I'm gonna get the request ready to create the first index. And this is the request here. So I'm gonna call the index. Today is the 8th. Firewall, the date, and then it has to be padded by this number. I don't know, this is the default. And you say aliases, and you call your alias, whatever it is, just the same name here. And you say is right index, and you say true, so that the first index created is actually the right index. I'm going to here stop logstash. I'm going to edit that file, that configuration file. So when I specify the ILM settings, so ILM rollover alias is the firewall or whatever custom name you want to put, the ILM pattern, so it will add this pattern, so the today's date dash these zeros and one, and then this number will increment at rollover, at the rollover. And then the ILM policy, you have to specify the same exact name, so you have to make sure it is exactly like here. And if you are using the ILM settings, you can't use the index setting here. So you can't name the index because ILM will name the indexes for you. So it'll be firewall dash the date dash 001. And then at the rollover, it will change. So I'm going to save that. And I'm going to start logstash. Or before I start logstash, I'll have to create the index template and the first firewall. So to recap, I created the policy, and then I'm going to create a template right here. I just click play, it is acknowledged true, and then I'll create the first index. And now I have the first index, and if I go to the stack management, index management, and this is the first index that I just created. That will be managed with the ILM policy, firewall index policy. These are not going to be receiving any more data. So it will. This is the first one that will receive the data. So I will go back to the ingestion server and start logstash. And I have another video about how I set up logstash to filter my firewall data. I have a Fortinet firewall, and I have another video on how to set up Elasticsearch and Kibana if you want to check those out. I'm going to check the status of logstash. It is running, and this index should be receiving some data here. The storage size is increasing, but not the document count. Let me see under discover. Under firewall. Okay, so it is working. I'll put the last 5 minutes. And it should be all of this data. If I can check the index, and for sure I have 382 documents. I don't know why it's not showing, or it's showing zero documents under index management. Yeah, it's still showing zero documents. This is a bug maybe, but it is working. I am ingesting the data, and the index is created using ILM in logstash settings. So I'm gonna wait for a few minutes, and I'm going to check that it actually rolled over. So I waited a little bit more than 5 minutes, and I can see I have a new index. My index rolled over, and it incremented this number to number 2. And this is just a lab setup. I made it to roll over every 5 minutes, but this is not very good practice. And my next index is not indexing. So I'm just gonna check the status here on logstash. Warning, I have warnings here. Could not index event logs to Elasticsearch. Okay, this is my field, this is the data. Team mapper. Parsing exception, reason, object mapping for service tried. Okay, I have issues with mapping, but not with rollover. So the settings for ILM are working, but mapping is different topic. But I have some issues with that. But the rollover is going okay. I'm going to show you another way to roll over an index with logstash using ILM, but without these numbers, because I don't like them. You see how logstash configuration file was creating an index with the today's date every day without this padded number here, which I don't like. You can do that without these settings here. So what I'm going to do is comment these out. I'll keep it normal with the index name here. I'm setting an index name padded with today's date, which I like more than this one. I'm going to save this file. I'm going to stop logstash. I'm going to delete these two. I'm going to look at my index lifecycle policies. So the policy that I'm going to be using, I'm not gonna enable rollover because logstash configuration or that Elasticsearch output plugin is creating an index every day with today's date. I don't want to roll over and add those numbers. So I'm just gonna disable rollover in the hot phase. And if you want to enable warm phase, cold phase, and for example, I'm going to keep this for 30 days and I'm going to save the policy. So I created the policy or edited the policy and disabled rollover. This is the other way. I'm going to go to the index template and my template here. I'm not going to change anything. So the settings of the index will specify the policy and the rollover alias. It will specify what is the rollover alias, which will match what I have in the configuration file. Mappings, I'm gonna keep these mappings. You can edit the mappings. So after I started logstash and I cleaned up the ILM settings and the output in Elasticsearch specifies the index name, now the data being indexed into Elasticsearch will match this index right here. And all I have to do now is right click here, or not right click, click here and select manage and add a lifecycle policy. And then I'm going to select the policy that I created, which is firewall index policy, add policy. And now I can see the information about the index lifecycle policy that this index is being managed by. So this is the other way. You create the policy, you don't enable rollover, you create the template, you specify the policy in the template, and in the logstash configuration, you just keep it creating the name that you want exactly. And you can set, you can make these different by only by today's date or by month and date, whatever it is. And then you have to come to the index here and actually specify the lifecycle policy. And I'm going to specify it on this one here manually as well. So those two indexes are now managed by the lifecycle policy. The one that will be created tomorrow will also be managed by the same lifecycle policy, and they will go through the data tiers if I have those set up, and then they will be deleted after 30 days. Check out my other video about index lifecycle management for an overview. And this was how to set up ILM with Logstash. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.